Hello students, today's topic is group and phase velocities and relation between them. As stated before, we have seen that according to Schrodinger's postulate, a moving material particle is equivalent to a wave packet rather than a single wave. Right? Now, I will use different formulas for this topic. These are based on certain mathematical and physical formulas. So, first formula which I have to use is the phase velocity or wave velocity is given by v suffix p equal to omega upon k, where omega is angular frequency, that is omega is equal to 2 pi by t. These are the formulas used in intermediate level, and we are using this in our topic today. And 1 by t is equal to nu, where t is time period and nu is called frequency. So it becomes 2 pi nu. And k is called wave number, that is k equal to 2 pi by lambda. Everybody knows it, that lambda is wavelength. And lambda is equal to Vp by nu. Lambda is equal to Vp by nu. So it becomes 2 pi nu by Vp. Now 2 pi nu is omega, so it becomes omega by Vp. How? Vp is nu lambda. This is true for any type of wave. Or from this, lambda equal to Vp by nu. And this is used here. The phase velocity is also given in terms of wavelength lambda and time period t of the wave. That is Vp equal to nu lambda. So lambda by t, because nu is 1 by t. Nu is 1 by t. Everything is written here. You have to note down only. And as mentioned yesterday, group velocity, which is denoted by capital G or Vg, and is also called, this group velocity is also called velocity of the wave packet. This is the another name of group velocity. You have to know all the terms. Sometimes capital G will be called group velocity. Sometimes it will be called velocity of the wave packet. The meaning is the same, physics is the same. Only nomenclature used are different. And group velocity is given by Vg equal to delta omega by delta k. By the simple mathematical rule of intermediate classes, if omega and k have continuous spreads means there is a continuity. And in that case, then the group velocity becomes, its mathematical writing will be Vg equal to d omega by dk. D is here differential d omega by dk, if it has continuous spreads. If not, then Vg is defined as like this. It is called delta omega by delta k. Now we will calculate the relation between group velocity and particle velocity. We have just now calculated that we know that the group velocity Vg should be equal to the velocity of the material particle V. This was proved in our previous class, that is a study class. Group velocity is equal to velocity of the material particle. And since omega has a formula, omega equal to 2 pi nu, and this is equal to 2 pi e by h, because e equal to h nu, so nu equal to e by h. All these formulas are used 3 or 4 times before. Now e equal to mc square, that is Einstein mass energy equivalence relation. So it becomes 2 pi mc square upon h. Now by the formula of dependence of mass on velocity in relativity, m is equal to m naught divided by root under 1 minus v square by c square. So put the value of m here, we get 2 pi m naught c square h root under 1 minus v square by c square, where m naught is called, discussed and said many times, rest mass, h Planck's constant, and capital E is total energy of the particle. So this formula omega now becomes 2 pi m naught c square by h, written here, it goes up 1 minus v square c square to the power minus 1 by 2, because denominator, when it comes to numerator, the root under is written as minus 1 by 2. Very simple thing, class 8th, 9th standard thing. Now we use the calculus and saying that differentiating the above equations, this one with respect to V, we will differentiate it with respect to V, we get after mathematical calculation, after differentiation, 2 pi m naught c square by h. So when it is differentiated, it becomes minus 1 by 2, 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 3 by 2, and again minus 2v by c square. How it becomes? By the differentiating a quantity with respect to another quantity, it comes out to be this one. So 2 pi m naught this v by h, 1 minus v square to the power minus 3 by 2, 2 and 2 cancel out, c square cancel out. Let it be equation number 1. Now come to about the wave number k. This wave number k is also called propagation constant, and it is expressed as, we have written already before, k equal to 2 pi by lambda. By de Broglie wavelength, we know that lambda equal to h by p. Lambda equal to h by p. So 1 by lambda equal to p by h ho jayega. So we write instead of lambda 2 pi p by h. Since a small m is mass of the particle and v is the velocity of the particle, so p becomes mv, it becomes 2 pi mv by h. Now m is equal to m naught root under 1 minus v square by c square, put the value of this m, we get 2 pi m naught v by h root under 1 minus v square by c square. For lambda I have written in bracketed form. This now, therefore, k now becomes 2 pi m naught v by h 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 1 by 2. Now the mathematical process is that differentiating k with respect to v, differentiating this k with respect to v using differential calculus, we get dk by dv, and when it is differentiated with respect to v, it becomes this one, right? You know the method of differentiation well. So after differentiating this with respect to v, we get this expression, and after simplifying it, 2 pi m naught h, it becomes 1 minus v square c square. Here this 2 and 2 cancel out, and v, and v becomes v square by c square, and put this value as it is. After this step, 2 pi m naught by h, take 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 3 by 2 common from these two terms. When you will take this common, you will get 1 minus v square by c square, right? When this and this is multiplied, you will get this one, this quantity. This quantity becomes now this, and it is taken as common, so only v square by, there will be v square by c square. Very simple, you can calculate it. Nothing to say like this, in which way I am speaking. This minus and plus cancel out, so it becomes 2 pi m naught h, m naught by h, 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 3 by 2. Let it be equation number 2. Yes. Now, dividing equation 1 by equation 2, we get d omega by dv into, it is reversed, dv by dk. The value of d omega by dv calculated in equation 1 is this one, and value of dk by dv is obtained in equation 2, and this is this one, it is reversed. These things are cancelled out, therefore we get d omega by dk. Note down here, you may not be able to see on the blackboard now because from here ink is changed there. So if you are writing, then writing 2 or 3 lines only, so that this topic will be finished. So d omega by dk equal to v, only v is remaining here. Let it be equation 3. We know that d omega by dk is equal to vg. Vg, that is group velocity. From equation 3 and 4, it is clear that vg equal to v. The group velocity is equal to velocity of the particle itself. What conclusion we got? You may note down here. I am saying slowly that thus the result becomes the group velocity of the wave group associated with the material particle is equal to the velocity of the particle. Velocity of the material particle. And the particle is most likely to be found at a point near the peak of the wave package. I am repeating this thing because I again saying that you may not see after this on the blackboard because on this whiteboard, because here, from here ink is changed and it may not be seen. If it is seen, then it's okay. This becomes this one, and this is equal to this one, d omega by dk vg. From 3 and 4 we get vg equal to v, and you have to write only 2 lines, and that is, I am saying that thus the group velocity of the wave group associated with the material particle is equal to the velocity of the material particle. Cholesterol. The particle is most likely to be found at a point near the peak of the wave packet. So here the question may be asked that prove that group velocity of the group of waves is equal to velocity of the moving material particle. And it completed here. So the other relation between group velocity and phase velocity will be discussed in our next class. Thank you. Thank you very much and wish you a nice day. Have you an answer? Okay, thank you.